I think they definitely do, because to begin with, our minds are just a series of chemical interactions, and so anything chemical can take the part in how that interacts with them, but how they think and everything. And so our bodies pretty much take care of themselves, but if substances are abused or we're exposed to things that we don't normally know how to deal with, that can have a great impact on how we think and how we develop.
Not in a good way, per se. I mean, you definitely start to lose control, I would say, and that's not ideal. I mean, you want to experience those things on your own accord, not being under the influence of certain things, so.
I guess if someone does drugs, I would hope that something they perceive as correct while they're on drugs isn't something they would perceive as correct while they're not on drugs. I'd hope there'd be a separation there. And I think for most people there probably is, but yeah, I'm not really sure.
Oh yeah, I think, I mean, like, if there is a biochemical reaction anytime you take anything, so depending on what it is, the bigger the change it will be. Absolutely does, yeah.
I truly believe that chemical substances, whether they be alcohol or drugs, affect our minds in different ways. And I know psychology has a lot to do with that because I've studied that. And I really do believe they affect our minds negatively. Causes us to look at things that should be taken more seriously, more lightly in a situation such as like drinking and then driving. Like you think, you know, you can handle it when actually you can't.
If you use a chemical substance or any sort of chemical substance, it can affect the way that your brain works. And so it can, you know, it can have an effect. It could be even a positive experience or obviously a very negative experience. You know, it'll affect the way that you think, either for a short period of time or for a long period of time.
Well, I mean, your body is pretty much all chemistry, so I'd assume chemicals have a way of changing your mind.
I guess it depends on what you take. Like, some people have, like, ADHD, and they have to take, like, medication to make them more focused, and, like, that, like, kind of enhances the learning experience, which they had a disadvantage with in the beginning. Whereas another student, like, who just, like, smoking marijuana a lot, I guess it could, like, make them lose focus. So it really depends on what you take.
Okay, so first of all, I better answer that question, yes, because I've spent my whole career investigating how chemicals change our minds. And of course, there's lots of different ways that they could, but I guess the one thing I'll give as an example, because in my research, we work with a lot of chemicals that are endocrine disruptors, so they can sort of masquerade as a hormone in the body, or they can block the effects of a natural hormone in the body. And through doing that, they can change the way the brain develops or the way the brain functions. And a really good example, one of the chemicals we work with is a class of chemicals actually called phthalates. And they reduce the production of testosterone, which is one of the sex steroids. And not everybody realizes this, but those steroid hormones are really important for brain development. So if not enough testosterone is produced when the fetus is developing, then the male brain may not develop to be quite as male as it otherwise would be, for example.
So the brain is a big consumer of energy. And the brain has, unless you're in a starvation condition, the brain has enough energy to keep you functioning. What we found more recently, and this gets to some of the work that I do, is that that different parts of the brain, when they're responding to processing new information, learning new things, those different, just being activated by sensory stimulation, those brain areas use more energy, and the energy that is generally supplied doesn't quite keep up. It isn't that there's a deficit, but you can actually see a drop-off of metabolism because it's being consumed so fast, faster than normal upkeep. So anything that would boost energy then is likely to improve processing, and in fact does. So things like administration of exogenous glucose, which can come from eating and it can come from injection of glucose. Doesn't matter too much how it gets there, but if you raise the glucose in the body, which ends up raising blood glucose levels, that then can feed the brain and the brain can do a better job. So even though the brain has enough energy so you don't fall over on your nose, if you unless you're starving, at the same time it's not functioning optimally unless it has a maximal amount of energy or an optimal amount of energy in reserve for brain function. So that's one sense in which chemicals, which can be derived from anything you eat, would affect the brain.
Yes, I mean, I think certainly they do. And they're one of the main categories of experiences that the brain gets, whether it's endogenous substances, chemicals that we take in, or whether it's the natural, did I say endogenous, exogenous substances that we take in, or endogenous substances that are already in our brains, those chemicals that actually do change the way the brain functions and then changes the way we think, all organisms and plants too, if you think that plants can think, but the way plants function and the way that and can change, you know, the output of the brain, and therefore I think the way we behave or the way we think.
Well, I mean, from kind of a neurobiological perspective, I think the way that they play a role in changing our minds is that they tap into the same biology that our brain uses to, give us what our mind turns out to be. So in that regard, I think the way that drugs can end up changing our minds is that they can kind of change our biology. And ultimately change the way that we think about the drug itself or our continued use of the drug, whether or not we should use it, whether it's a good thing, whether it's a bad thing. So I think the way that drugs can end up changing our minds is very directly. In other words, like I said, they kind of tap into the same biology that our brain uses, but also kind of indirectly in that they can change our overall behaviors in a more general kind of way.
Well, we know that neurotransmitters are extremely important in all neuronal actions, and so obviously chemicals play a role. Secondly, we know that neurotransmitters and other chemicals affect our mood, and that is obviously going to affect how we perceive information. I don't know exactly how that does it. Again, I'm not a neuroscientist, but it's definitely going to have an impact. And that means then that in addition to the chemicals that are innate in our body, you have to assume that any chemical that gets to the brain is going to be able to influence the way our opinions and how we think about something. I would go further and say that because our emotions can be affected by things that are not in our brain, actually. For example, if we have a stomach ache, we feel definitely less happy about the world than if we don't. That means that any chemical anywhere in the body can probably affect our decision-making ability in any case, and our thought processes.